So there's one thing. I will slightly repeat what she just said, because we are also a training program for producers. I think one of the biggest differences is that we are a workshop for advanced producers. So producers who are a bit further in their career. I think that's something you should keep in mind. There's a lot of producers who do EAVE first, and then a few years later, they come and join ACE. I also did EAVE, and I can highly recommend it. Before I start with my own great program. I should do it like this. So just a bit the history of ACE. Next year we will be celebrating 25 years of ACE. It was initiated by British as well as French producers. For a very long time based in Paris, and we recently moved, actually earlier this year, we moved to Amsterdam, the Netherlands. And since that time, I'm also the director of the association, because we are an association. The reason why these established producers set it up was really that they wanted to have sort of a hub to share experiences, to share knowledge. To facilitate co-production in that sense. Co-production is really the core of what ACE is about. So when you come to ACE with your project, it should be also suitable for co-production. That's something you should keep in mind. We are an association, so when you're a member, you also have a vote. So we have a board of 20 established producers, but not only producers, there's also other film professionals. For example, Yves Cabareau, who set up Soda Pictures here in the UK, he's one of our board members. Simon Perry is still our president. He used to run, long time ago, British Screen, and he's also he was head of the Irish Film Board, and he's been with us for a very long time. We trained about 430 producers over all those 25 years. I think now, by now, we have 200 producers who are active in the network. So there's producers who unfortunately passed away, or they are doing other professions at the moment. So around at about 200 who are active and members of ACE. And they are from not only Europe, they are from 48 countries, so the main part is from Europe. But we had, in the past, we also had producers programs for non-European producers. At the moment, we're not doing that. We used to run a program in Hong Kong, and we used to do, we used to invite producers from other territories like Colombia or Brazil and Japan. The program was called ACE Mundus, but because of a lot of difficulties in their respective territories with funding, we stopped it. The only organization we're still working with and very close with is Telefilm Canada. That's why we also have Canadian producers in our current program. So when you're becoming part of the network, because that's what Sato was saying as well, you know, you follow the whole workshop. I'll be telling about that later. But you become part of a network, and those become your peers. Those become the people you call, you get advice from, you get knowledge from different territories. I think that's something which you really have to keep in mind, is that you're just one phone call away from getting information. That's constantly what we find out during this workshop, is that if you, not only UK, but the whole European continent, rules and funding rules are changing constantly. So us, ourselves as well, you can't keep up to date. And that's why it's important to be able to pick up the phone, talk to a German producer, okay, what in your region, what's now the status, how can I apply, what are the reciprocity or anything like that. I'll get to the workshops later, but when you become part of the network, you pay an annual fee, which is €250. For that, you will get a lot of benefits, which I will get to later. And you can also participate in our annual reunion. That's done yearly. Next year we will do it in Tallinn in Estonia. So like EIAVA, we do that each year in a different territory. And when you participate in your union, you will pay an additional 250 euros. That's a gathering where the current ACE members, the current ACE producers are met up with the producers from the network. So next year, since we will be celebrating 25 years, we expect quite a lot. So usually it's between 60 to 80. I think this year will be a bit more. But it will be producers who did ACE about 22 years ago until now. So it's really a big variety of producers attending. I think what is important to mention is that when you're part of ACE, that's what, at least, I mean, that's what Lisa Marie and maybe the other producers will say later on as well, is when you've participated in ACE, it's sort of a quality stamp. I get asked, a lot of ACE producers call me up throughout the year, like, oh, I'm actually looking for a producer in this and this territory. Who are the ACE producers currently still active in that territory? I got an email from one of our Swedish producers, I'll mention him later, yesterday, like, oh, I want to find a co-producer in Canada. And then they always want to reach out to their own peers in that sense, because ACE is sort of, they know they can trust these people. They know they have a certain level of trust and everything around it. So, about the workshops. We select 16 to 20 producers each year. This year we have 18, 16 from Europe, 2 from Canada. And then we have 3 workshops throughout the year. So it's a yearly program. And the first workshop is in October, and that's the content development workshop. I will go a bit more into detail about the programs in a bit. The second we just wrapped up 2 weeks ago, which was in Prague, and that was the financing strategies workshop. And then we sort of wrap up with the business prospects workshop, followed immediately by the annual reunion, where what I was mentioning early on, where all the other network producers are joining. And that's literally a trip. Everyone comes to Amsterdam, or the 18 producers come to Amsterdam, and we all fly together to this next year. It will be Tallinn. So it's sort of a field trip as well. I think what is very important to mention is that ACE is only for producers. So the difference, like for example with EIAVA, is that you can, to the first 2 workshops, you can bring your scriptwriter. With us, it's solistically for producers. We really want to build their skills and they can take their knowledge home, because for example we have a content development workshop which is all about script and script editing, but the people take their knowledge home and bring that across again to their writer, director and everyone. We also don't take other film professionals into their program. Like me, for example, I have never been a producer, but I participated in EIAVA because I was interested in the field of producing, and that's a possibility with them, but that's with us not a possibility. And of course, one of the bigger differences is that we're a lot smaller, so we only accept like up to 20, but that's already quite a lot of producers. And because it's so small, I think it creates, within no time, you create sort of trust between each other. You're put into a room for 6 days in a row, and you're constantly thinking about your project, pitching your project, and at the end of the week, they're all singing in a karaoke bar in Helsinki this time. and there's one other thing. When we talk about professionals coming to ACE, we don't really call them tutors, because the producers who attend our program, they're already quite advanced, so we talk about consultants. So everyone is each other's consultant. So it's not that when someone from a sales agency is coming that there's a difference in level or something like that. So the first workshop is the content development workshop. The biggest part of this workshop is something which we call the story type method, which is done by Emmanuel Aubert. He's a fantastic script editor, and he really runs 3 full days of script editing. And what I like about him, just to briefly explain, is that you have a lot of great script editors or great people who are doing these talks. He's not really a sort of a preacher, but he hands tools which you can sort of take in, and some tools you will take home and some not, but he's not preaching a whole religion in that sense. And I think for the level of our producers, it's good that it's not like a fixed thing. Then on the first day, we have a pitching training, which is almost a whole day for the producers to get to know each other, to get to know each other's projects. I mean, they read each other's projects, but it's really good to sort of see them talk about it before. And then there's different elements about how to deal with your talents, how to deal with conflict with your talents. Explain each other about how to write intention notes and how to deal with that and everything. So this workshop is completely focused on content development. Then the second one, which we just wrapped up, that is actually sort of the big workshop. We invite about 35 to 40 consultants from Europe, UK, North America, sales agents, distributors, online distributors, but also a lot of producers from our program, like Lisa Marie, who will join us later. She is one of the consultants in the room. And the main sessions during this workshop is around the finance plans. So every producer, all the 18 producers, they present their finance plans, and it's actually sort of a setup like this. Like for example, we have a producer from the Netherlands. She is looking for a German co-producer and maybe a Belgium co-producer. She presents her finance plan, and then we go through it step by step. And since there's professionals from all these different territories, everyone shoots. They have like 45 minutes to an hour to shoot on what they see, because what I was saying early on is that when you're not from Germany, you're not aware of all these regional funds and how it all works. So everyone will deliver input, and the great thing is that it's not only for the people presenting, but it's also very valuable for the consultants who are there. So we don't have a problem in inviting consultants, highly established consultants, because it's always sort of an annual update about the European system and beyond. Like for example, we also had Bertrand Favre, who has the bureau and Le Bureau, and we did Simon, our president, he interviewed him about why he has two companies, and that's quite a special case in that sense. And we do these interviews quite a lot because that's what I hear, because I mean, we're organizing it in the end for the producers. It's what is really nice is to hear about a certain career and about certain steps someone makes and about the choices someone makes. And Bertrand was in this case very interesting to hear why he decided to have a company in London as well as in Paris. And we have also a lot of funding bodies present, like Isabel Davies from BFI was there as well. She could explain about the system here. So that brings all these different territories together. We have other sessions. I will just dive in quickly. We always organize a sales case study. So we screen the film, and then usually we have Sebastian Beffa, who formerly Films Distribution, now Playtime. He talks about a film and why they are selling the film and how they are selling film. This year it was BPM by Robin Campillo. And what was really nice about that session this year, and I heard it also from others, is that there's a lot of other sales agents and distributors in the room. And these other sales agents, they sort of bounce back between each other. And at a certain moment, we all had the feeling that the sales agents and distributors, that they thought that we weren't there anymore. So we were like, sort of eavesdropping, you know? So he creates sort of a vibe that, okay, finally there's real numbers on the table, and why did he make these choices and everything? Then it's not always an easy ride. So we also, we have a consultant, Andrew Hildebrand, who's here based in the UK. And he does a session about how to handle any dispute. Because that is unfortunately sometimes also the case, and very valuable for our producers to think about, okay, how can we, which steps can we take before we have to go to court? In some cases it happens. Then the third workshop is the business prospects workshop. I'll move on a bit quickly, more quickly. Also about sustainable company management, marketing techniques, distribution. And we constantly try to adapt to the ever-changing industry and the world around us. I mean, this especially sales and distribution is changing a lot in these days. So we try to keep an ear to the ground and see what we should adapt and see what we should change within the program as well. So that's why we as a team, because it's not only me within ACE, but there's also three of my colleagues. We travel a lot to other festivals and we attend a lot of seminars to sort of see, okay, what is currently in people's minds and the business. And something I should not forget to mention is that I think case studies are usually the most valuable for, I mean, that's what I hear from the producers, is just really talking about a film. We had, for example, this 2 weeks ago, we had Ed Gainey, who produced The Killing of a Sacred Deer. He's an ACE producer. And he literally talked about his process, first producing The Lobster with Yorgos, and then going into The Killing, and now the favorite is, I mean, in post-production, and going through a career with the director and the choices he makes and the difficulties he also experiences. It's really, everyone puts it on the table. And I think because we try to really build something which is about trust, which is essential, because otherwise people don't share. And it is all about sharing this knowledge, because you only learn, I think, from mistakes and from failures. The other, or I mean, yes, me, myself, but also when you talk about that, other people can learn from that. Okay, that's what the annual reunion, that is what I was saying earlier on, the gathering of the year for all the ACE producers. This year it will be in Tallinn, and there we talk also about business strategies, really about how to create, like Satu was also saying, that they do that in EAFA, how to also have a sustainable business, because it's not only about one production, but it's usually about several productions, and how many do you have in development, and all the factors around that. But this annual reunion, it's not completely packed, because it's also a gathering and it's also a way for everyone to catch up, because most of the people might see each other already at festivals, but at festivals you have busy schedules, so this is really like to relax and to chat and to tell each other, and there's of course a whole lot of co-productions evolving out of that. Then the benefits. So each participant will get a designated script, financing and marketing consultant, and they will meet these consultants at the first workshop. The financing consultants, they will meet at the financing strategies workshop, the second, and then all of them will meet again at the last workshop, and they will have possibilities, because sometimes you don't have an updated version of the script, so we're not rigid in that you, I don't have a version for the next workshop, so then you can do online meetings, or we facilitate the matter that you meet your consultants at festivals. Then we have, next week we're actually launching, because we have a whole, we used to be known under a very different house style and brand, and we created a new style, and we created a new website, and we also have a login area for our producers, where most up-to-date information about each other's co-productions, productions they can find. And we also have an area where we can put our recorded sessions, because we have very interesting sessions during the training, but then all the 200 active producers who are in the network weren't there, so it's also available for them. And then there's maybe one nice thing is that we gather a lot at festivals. like EAVE, we even do drinks together with EAVE and with other training organizations, just to catch up and to facilitate and to matchmake. But what we also do with ACE is that we created think tanks. So we've done two now this year. Is that, and we put about 8 to 10. No, I think more 8 producers around the table. It's moderated. They have 3 hours, and they talk about specific subjects they find relevant at the time of the event to talk about. And it's, I mean, we found out it has to be very specific subjects. So this time and last time, it was about distribution and the ever-changing world around that. And what's good about that is that they never take 3 hours to talk with each other like that. It's just that everyone is busy, and it was very valuable. And we create reports out of that. And these reports we share with our producers, but also with the outside world. So these are our festival partners. I think a lot EAVE is also partnering with. The one I want to mention is EFM. Because that's a new collaboration, that's the European Film Market in Berlin, where we as ACE will be hosting their producers hub. So they have a hub within the EFM building where producers can do their meetings if they have a market badge. Can do their meetings, but we also create a program. There's roundtables, there's short panels, and this is not only for ACE producers, this is for all producers attending the Berlinale. With a market badge, that's something to keep in mind. Then with Cinemart, for example, we sent producers to the Rotterdam Lab, which is their training program. We have different setups, like Sato was saying. Depends on the market, but it's it could be beneficial for certain producers. So we always send out a call, like Mia, for example, in Rome. They accept 2 ACE projects, so it goes through us, and they facilitate it all. Then, finally, we get there, the eligibility. So you have to be an owner, a partner, or an associate of an independent production company based in the European Union or a media program country, so you're still in, and I hope you will still stay in. And if it's not the case, we always have this 20% rule that we can accept producers, 20% of the 18 producers we can accept from outside of media countries. It is important when you apply for ACE that you need to have produced, I say really at least, within brackets, at least 1 feature film as a delegate producer. So you can apply when you have produced 1 film, but most of the producers who applied have produced already several films. It really varies this year from 1, 2 to, I don't know, 12, 14. So there's everyone, it should be like Sato was saying, you should really think about, is it the right time in my career? Do I have the right project suitable for co-production? Is it in the right stage of development? Do I have a script which still needs some work? Do I have to find co-producers? So that's something you have to think about. A fiction feature project, that's something to keep in mind. Sometimes we do accept also documentaries, but most of the consultants and most of the program is focused on fiction features. And then, of course, you need to have the time. Because usually the producers who apply for ACE, they are pretty active producers, so also have projects sometimes in production. So I met a producer who I was really... I thought it was strange that he wasn't part of the ACE network yet. And he said, I actually have been thinking about it for 6 years, but every time either I didn't have a right project in development or I was in production of film during one of the courses. So it really, the timing is quite essential in that matter. Then how to apply. What we do is... it's not an open application process. So we talk with everyone. We talk at festivals, we talk mainly at the Berlinale and in Cannes with producers interested or at events like this. because what I was saying just before is about the eligibility and really also checking what kind of project do you have, is it indeed suitable? And usually in a conversation we find out, I think, or we advise, maybe you should do it next year because of these and these reasons. Because applying for a program like this takes quite some time. You really need to fill out all these this information. So before doing that, we have about, I think, 80 to 100 producers interested, but we sent about 35 application forms. So that's really narrowed down. And then these 35 producers, they apply, and then we invite about, I think this year we invited about 27 producers to come for an interview, a live interview in Amsterdam or in Toronto, because it was also Canadian producers. And then you have, I believe it's half an hour. Was it half an hour, Colin? I can't remember. Half an hour interview. And then you have an interview with the six people who are in the committee, because they're reading all the scripts and the whole application form. So it could be quite intense. So the application forms are sent in May, and the deadline next year is the 11th of June, so before that time we need to receive it. Then the commission reads it all over the summer. We make a short list early July, and then we do the interviews in September, and then even the same day or a day later, we call everyone if you're selected or not. If you're interested, we have a producers liaison, and she's called Elle Williams. Her details are there, but I'm also here, of course, still. Then Agnieszka asked us to mention some recent successes. So Erik Hemmendorf, he's a Swedish producer who just won with the Square the Palme d'Or. We had 23 projects or films in the TIFF selection. Oscar nomination for Tony Erdmann by two ace producers. They're in the same company. And then Thierry Collard, based in France, is a producer who will receive the Producers Award at EFA. EFA is the European Film Awards. He will receive that tomorrow. That's actually tomorrow. So, I think that's it. I don't know how long I took. I'm sorry about that.